another video. Today we are going to be doing a memory verse video with you guys. It's been a while since we've not been learning any memory verses from the Bible, and so we thought today would be a good time for us to do a new verse. We're going to be doing it in a little bit different way to the way we normally do it, but you know, reading the Bible is so important, so we thought, you know what, we need to be learning some more verses from the Bible, because you guys all know Psalm 23 by now, don't you? You all know it off by heart, you're saying it in your sleep, so I understand, kids. So now, today we're going to be learning a verse that's in the Bible towards the end of the New Testament this time. Not in the Old Testament, not in the Psalms, but in the New Testament. And it's written in a book called Philippians. Yeah, Philippians chapter 4 and verse 13. And this book, kids, is a letter sent by the Apostle Paul whilst he's in prison to a church in Philippi. So Apostle Paul in the Bible, who is a servant of the Lord Jesus, who serves the Lord Jesus and preaches the gospel in the Bible, he is in prison. And he sends a letter to the Christians who are in the church in a place called Philippi. Now, kids, if you're wondering, what, like I was at your age, where on earth is this place called Philippi? Well, have a look at this map here next to me and you'll be able to see where exactly it is on the map. Yeah. No, can't you see it, kids? No? One sec. This map here, kids. No, can you see it now? Yeah, this map. There we go. So on this map, as you can see, this is where Paul would have sent his letter to. And in this place here, in this map that you can see, that is a place called Philippi. So anyway, Paul sent this letter over, and he was in prison at the time. He was going through a lot of difficulties as a human being and as a person would be, and as a Christian as well, I suppose, because you see, he was away from his friends, he was away from the other Christians, but he still managed to communicate and to pass on certain teachings to the people that served in different churches in the area and in around Europe. So basically, kids, Philippi was a major Greek city in Greece, and that's where Paul was sending this letter to. Now, Paul was sending this letter, so imagine, you're a guy in prison, all right, and you're not really going to be very happy in prison, because you're away from your friends, you're away from your family, you're away from the people that you love, who you normally spend time with, and he's there in prison. And instead of moping and getting down about it and getting into a sulk, he's sending letters out to different churches. And this one that he sent to the town called Philippi was sent to encourage the believers there. Now in chapter 2 of Philippians, okay, Paul is saying to them to be like the Lord Jesus, to carry on being humble like the Lord Jesus was, to carry on serving him, and to basically be lights in a dark world. And also, kids, in the last chapter, in chapter 4 of Philippians, Paul then goes on to explain how we should be happy and content in whatever circumstance that we're in. So in whatever difficulty that we may be going through as Christians, if you've trusted in the Lord Jesus as your Saviour, you can be confident and sure that whatever you're going through, the Lord Jesus will be with you every step of the way. And we can be encouraged, kids, that whatever the difficulty, whether it be this virus, or whether it be a difficulty at school, or whether whatever challenges that you're going through, because I don't know what challenges you are going through, but I certainly went through quite a few when I was at school and when I was your age and with different friends. I didn't get on with all my friends, and sometimes I struggled to create strong friendships with people, and I struggled sometimes to find people that I could relate to and who are like me and who could understand me. But you know, the more I got to know the Lord Jesus and to trust in him with my thoughts, with my prayers, the more I found that he would help me through them. Anyway, kids, so we're going to now learn this verse. I've got the verse here, and the verse, we thought that today we will teach you the verse in English and in another language. So we don't just teach you Bible verses in English here at Explorers, kids. We teach you them in other languages as well. So the verse that we're going to learn is Philippians chapter 4, verse 13. And it starts by saying this: I can do all things. Okay, so far, I can do all things through him who... Now, this him is the Lord Jesus Christ. And some other versions say through Christ. So through Christ who, so through him who strengthens me. So there you have it, kids. It's not a long verse. It's not a difficult verse. It starts like this: I can do all things through him who strengthens me. Philippians chapter 4, verse 13. But we're not going to stop there. We're going to teach it you in Portuguese as well. We're going to teach it you in two languages so that you can now say to your parents, can you say a Bible verse in Portuguese? And chances are they won't be able to, but maybe they can, I don't know. Anyway, and if there's anyone watching these videos who doesn't speak English properly, or it's not your native language, then maybe you can learn it in English. Anyway, we're going to learn it in Portuguese now, and I've got an assistant to help me to do that. So, I can do all things through him who strengthens me. Now, Sammy's going to teach it you in Portuguese.
Tudo posso naquele que me fortalece. Now, let's say together. Tudo.
Oh, me. All right. Tudo.
Posso.
Posso.
Naquele que.
Naquele que.
Me.
Me.
Fortalece.
Fortalece.
One more time.
Yeah, one more time. Go on. Yeah.
Tudo.
Tudo.
Posso.
Posso.
Naquele.
Naquele.
Que.
Que.
Me.
Me.
Fortalece.
Fortalece. Right, kids. So, that's me. That's Milan. And what's the reference for yours?
Philippians 4:13.
Right, kids. So, we're going to say this a few more times. And then, by next Sunday, you'll all know it in your sleep. At least you better had to, because I'm teaching it now. Now then, let's do it. So, I can do all things.
I can do all things.
Through him.
Through him.
Who.
Who.
Strengthens.
Strengthens.
Me.
Me.
One more time in English, guys. I can.
I can.
Do all things.
Do all things.
Through him.
Through him.
Who.
Who.
Strengthens me.
Strengthens me.
Philippians chapter 4. Verse 13.
Philippians chapter 4, verse 13.
Now in Portuguese again, and I'll have to repeat it.
Tudo.
Tudo.
Posso.
Posso.
Naquele.
Naquele.
Que.
Que.
Me.
Me.
Fortalece.
Fortalece.
Filipenses.
Filipenses.
4.
4.
13.
13. One more time.
Tudo.
Tudo.
Posso.
Posso.
Naquele.
Naquele.
Que.
Que.
Me.
Me.
Fortalece.
Fortalece.
Filipenses.
Filipenses.
4.
4.
13.
13. Right. That's it. So, kids, by next week, I am expecting you to know it off by heart. In actual fact, I'm expecting you to teach me the verse. Never mind me teach you guys the verse, okay? So, we'll go over it again in a future video, don't worry. And that's it from us. So on behalf of everyone from Brownwood Hall, kids, take care. See ya!